النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, he also teaches us that the word Alhamdulillah is enough to fulfill all your worldly requests and your hereafter needs as well. Where do we learn this from? When we rise from our ruku', we say, سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَهُ. Did you ever wonder what that meant? سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَهُ means Allah has answered the call and the request of the one who praises and thanks Him by saying Alhamdulillah. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says in the authentic hadith, أَفْضَلُ الدُّعَاءُ أَلْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ, that the best dua one could make is saying Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. But you might wonder and ask, how is the word Alhamdulillah a dua? How is it a dua? Al-ulama rahimahumullah, they say that when one says Alhamdulillah, he is saying, oh Allah, I acknowledge your blessing and I acknowledge your favor upon me. And oh Allah, I ask you to continue this blessing and to continue this favor upon me until I meet you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. We also learn in the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that one of the rights of a Muslim towards his Muslim brother or sister is that when a person sneezes, he says, Alhamdulillah. And in response, we're supposed to say, Yarhamuk Allah. And then the one that sneezed would say, Yahdikum Allah wa yuslih balakum. Have you ever noticed this sequence right here, what's happening? First, the one who sneezed said, Alhamdulillah. He praised and he thanked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After that, he heard, Yarhamuk Allah. In other words, when one properly makes hamd of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the result of this is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses him with his mercy. And if Allah azza wa jal was to encompass and envelop someone with his mercy, that leads to يَهْدِيكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيُصْلِحْ بَالَكُمْ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would guide such a person. Subhanallah.